Hey everyone, thank you so much for watching today's video. Today I am going to show you a soft, glittery, glamorous eye look, kind of like Foxy inspired by going for kind of a pointy inner corner and a wink liner. So hopefully this is going to give you some inspiration for your makeup. Now before I go in with any eyeshadow, I am first going to prime my eyelids, and I'm using the MAC Cosmetics Pink Pot in the color Soft Ochre, which is my favorite eyeshadow primer. It removes the redness from the eyelid, and it also makes sure that my whole eyeshadow is gonna stay in place all day. So I'm gonna use this palette from Maven Beauty. I'm not sure what the name is, but I will make sure to link it down in the description bar together with all the other products I am using today. So I'm gonna start with this light brownish shade and mixing it with that color, kind of doing a mixture of both colors, and those are also the only two colors I am going to use. I wanted to keep it really simple today, so I'm focusing a little bit more on the wing liner and that pointy inner corner that I created, and try to make the eyeshadow application kind of minimal and just easy. So I hope you guys like that. So I just blend this shade like straight in my crease area, going back and forth with my brush, also making circular motions to make sure that it's as blended out as possible. However, I had some problems with blending it out. I think because I didn't set the eyeshadow primer with powder, which I don't always do, but I applied the eyeshadow directly after the primer, so the eyeshadow primer was still a little bit sticky, which kind of led to this problem. So I just continued to blending until I was satisfied with how everything was looking, and then I went in with this eyeshadow, which is from NYX Cosmetics. I actually received this in their advent calendar, so it was for me the first time trying it out, and it's actually nice. It's a nice color, but I had some problems with the color payoff. I had to go in a few times with my finger to get it to look nicely covered, which normally with shades like this, it doesn't take so much effort, so therefore I would not recommend this eyeshadow because it just didn't work the way I wanted it to be. Now for this eye look, I wanted to go in with a liquid eyeshadow, so I'm gonna apply this on top, so it didn't matter, but regardless of that, I would not recommend since I had such a hard time. So now I'm going in with this liquid eyeshadow from Maven Beauty, applying it straight on top of that eyeshadow from NYX Cosmetics. So this is kind of going to cover it up anyway, but if I use a liquid eyeshadow, I always like to use a shimmery eyeshadow underneath, so it just looks so much better. It's kind of hard for me to explain, but applying an eyeshadow underneath a liquid eyeshadow, it just looks so much better. And after applying the liquid eyeshadow, I used a clean brush, kind of going around the edges to make sure that there are no harsh lines, kind of like smudging it into the eyeshadow in the crease area. So everything looks really nicely blended out together. And therefore, I used a Sigma Beauty E25 brush, which is a really nice brush. So I'm just continuing to do this and until I was satisfied, and then I went in with this liquid eyeliner, also from Maven Beauty, which I also used in my previous video. It's actually really nice because you can twist the outer end of the liquid liner. This way there will always be a liquid in the point of the, well, not the point, the tip of the liner, and this way it's never gonna dry out, which I think is genius. So for this video, I wanted to include a little bit more of the eyeliner process because sometimes I only show like a little part of it. So today I wanted to show you a bit more of that since I think it's actually quite important. Since it's kind of making the whole look, so therefore I wanted to show you. So the first thing I always do is create a simple line above the lash line, and then I drag a line from the outer end of the eyelid kind of towards my brow. I'm not gonna drag it all the way towards the end of my brow, but kind of like following that line to make sure that it's in the same direction. And now I'm going to create that wink liner. Where you apply the wink line, it kind of depends on your eye shape, but make sure that when you create that wink liner, you open your eyes a few times to see if it looks good or not, so you can apply a little bit more and more. So now I'm going in with this light brown color from a Maven Beauty palette and using a Sigma Beauty flat definer brush to apply this all the way underneath lower lash line. So sweeping my brush back and forward to making sure that that shade is all the way there. So I have a special discount code for Sigma Beauty, which you can use. I have it linked down in the description bar. They have my favorite brushes. They are amazing quality. You know, with some brushes, the hairs will stick out, but these ones are actually so good and they will last you such a long time. So if you are ever searching for a good makeup brush, Sigma Beauty has amazing ones to choose from. I will make sure to link all my favorite ones in the description bar. So now after applying that eyeshadow underneath the lower lash line, I created that pointy inner corner. I just felt like I haven't done that for a while, so I wanted to do that for today's video because it just kind of gives the eye look kind of a different twist. So I'm creating that pointy inner corner using that liquid liner from Maven Beauty. I'm kind of dragging it a little bit further, like underneath the lower lash line. You can keep it the way it was, but I like to drag it a little bit further. Now for the waterline, I took a pencil from ColourPop in collaboration with Raw Beauty Christie. This is a really beautiful warm brown shade. So now it's time to curl my lashes because it's time for mascara and I always curl my lashes before mascara. So my lashes are going to be a little bit more lifted and you will see no hairs kind of like right before my eyeball or somewhere. But now it's time for mascara and I use the Roller Lash Mascara from Benefit, which is my all-time favorite. I absolutely love this mascara. So I'm using this for my lashes. And of course, I am going in with fake lashes, but if you recreate this makeup look and you're not a huge fan of lashes, of course, you can skip this part and leave it with mascara. I have a video on my channel where I show you how to apply lashes. I will make sure to link that in the description bar. And then this is the finished result. I really hope you all enjoyed. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you did enjoy. Also, I want to wish you all a Merry Christmas. And if you don't celebrate Christmas, I just wish you all an incredible week. And I hope to see you all in my next video. Bye, guys.